Electric field. So when we talk about electric field, you can see in the diagram or the picture over here, a charge is going to create its effect around it. Okay, the effect created by the charge around it in form of these lines, you can see, we call it as electric field. Now, the specialty of this electric field is somewhere you can see that these lines are very close to each other, somewhere they are away from each other. So you know, wherever they are close, we would consider the electric field to be high with strength. Whereas wherever they are apart from each other, the strength would be comparatively low. Now you try to bring some other charge or the test charge in this field. Then what would happen if you try to bring test charge in this field? Then in that case, there would be a reaction from the electric field which is already present.
Okay, sir.
Either that reaction would be in form of force of attraction or force of repulsion. So when we talk about electric field, friends, these are the points which we need to consider. We all know like charges, they would repel, and unlike charges, they would attract. Okay. So they would attract or repel even if there is no medium between them. Now, why would that happen? Because of the electric field formed around an electric charge, which was being shown in the previous picture. Here you can see every charge will form an electric field around it. Now, you try to bring other charge in that field. What's going to happen is it would experience a force either of repulsion or of attraction, because of the electric field which was present due to the first charge. Therefore, we need to know what type of force would be exerted on that test charge, okay? Whether that force would be maximum or comparatively less. It all depends upon how is the strength of the electric field. The quantity which gives us the measure of the strength of electric field is electric intensity. So here onwards, remember, electric intensity is the measure of strength of electric field. How do we define electric intensity then? So we define electric intensity in terms of the force which is being experienced by any other charge, which when comes in the effect of electric field produced by the first charge. Or in simple words, you can also call electric intensity as the force acting on unit positive test charge placed at that point. So here you can have a look at it. If the small test charge, say Q naught, is placed in the electric field and E stands for electric intensity. So electric intensity is the force acting on this test charge. And then electric intensity will be given in form of an equation, E bar equal to F bar divided by Q naught, or in simple words, it is as per the definition of electric intensity. Again, I will repeat the definition for you to understand this equation. Electric intensity is defined as the force acting on test positive charge present in the electric field. So this is something which you need to, you know, realize, understand. It's a vector quantity because we are talking about force, and force is a vector quantity. Therefore, electric intensity will also be a vector quantity. Because it is force per unit charge, the unit would be Newton per Coulomb or volt per meter. The dimensions for electric field intensity are M1, L1, T raised to minus 3 and I raised to minus 1, where I is the fundamental quantity called as electric current. So let's talk about the derivation of electric field intensity due to a point charge. So we are considering a charge Q, which is placed at point A, as shown in the diagram, you can see. And There is another test charge Q naught, which we try to bring in the vicinity of the electric field produced because of Q. So let it be situated at point B as shown in the figure, and let the distance between A and B be r, small r. And obviously, because both are positively charged, the electric intensity or the force acting on B would be directed away from it. It would be a repulsive force. So here you can see the electric intensity is directed away from B over here, or away from A in this case. So if we talk about the unit vector which specifies the direction of the Coulomb's force, so Coulomb's force is directed from A towards B, and therefore this is the direction of electric intensity. And it's given by, Coulomb's force is given by F bar equal to, we all know, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q naught upon R square. And in vector form, obviously it has to be associated with a unit vector U cap, which gives us the direction of this force. Let this be equation 1. So as per this equation, we get the value for the force acting on Q naught. But as per the definition of electric intensity, we all know electric intensity is force acting on the charge Q naught, which is placed in the vicinity of Q. So we know the equation for force. We will put the equation for force over here. And then the equation for electric intensity becomes 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square to U cap. Why? Because Q naught gets cancelled over here from the previous equation for force. So this is the equation for electric intensity. 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square into U cap. Had one of the charge being negative, then the direction of electric intensity would have been inwards towards the charge. This U cap is the unit vector which gives the direction of the electric intensity, which is acting at point B. Denoted by notation equation 2. So if Q is positive, as I've said, the intensity is directed away from it. If the charge Q was negative, then the intensity would have been directed towards it. So finally, this is in terms of vector notations or in terms of direction. Only in terms of magnitude, electric intensity will be then given as E equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. So from this equation 3, you can see this electric intensity will be dependent on the magnitude of charge. If the magnitude of charge is more, electric intensity will be high. That means electric strength at that particular point near the charge would be high, and vice versa. Electric intensity also depends on the distance from the charge. If the distance increases, electric intensity decreases, and vice versa. When we talk about uniform electric field, when the magnitude as well as direction of the electric field as shown in the diagram, you can see it remains same at all the points. So at all the points, the direction of electric intensity is same, the magnitude is same. So the lines are parallel lines, you can see, and equidistant lines. So such field, we will call it as uniform electric field. Now, if this direction or the magnitude of electric intensity changes from place to place in the field in this manner, as shown in the diagram, then we will call such field as non-uniform electric field. So in the radial field, you can see electric intensity at any point is directed either towards the charge or away from the charge, or the same fixed point. And in such situations, we will call this field as radial electric field. So electric line of force. So basically, it's an imaginary path which would be described by a free positive charge placed in the electric field. Now, whenever you try to place a free test positive charge in the electric field, it would be experiencing a force of repulsion or attraction. accordingly it will start moving in the electric field, and that path itself will be called as electric line of force. So obviously these lines of forces in different electric fields would be presented differently. Had it been an isolated positive charge, if I try to bring a test positive charge in this field, it will be thrown away from it in the direction of electric intensity. So for isolated positive charge, the direction of electric line of force is outwards. For negative, it is exactly opposite. It would be inwards. It would be attracted by the negative charge. So for a pair of a charge, okay, pair of like charge, you know, the lines of forces would be somewhat like this. They would be repelling each other. You can see. Whereas whenever it's a pair of unlike charges, we also call it as an electric dipole, equal and opposite charges. You can see these lines, they converge. So converge towards negative. They originate from positive and they move, terminate towards negative. Had it been a plane conductor carrying equal and opposite charges, the situation or the situation would be represented by this diagram. You can see the lines of force move from positive to negative. Now there are many things to be understood over here in this diagram. You can see, if I want the direction of electric intensity at any point, what I will do, say for example, if I want it at this point, I will draw a tangent. I want it at this point, I will draw a tangent to this. I want it at this point, I will draw a tangent to this. So a tangent drawn to electric line of force at any point will give me the direction of electric intensity. This is the first point to be noted. Second point, you can see they never intersect each other. Now, what does that mean? Why are they never intersecting? These lines of forces are never intersecting each other. Somewhere they are coming close to each other. Somewhere they are moving away from each other, but they never intersect. Now, why they never intersect? Because there always exists a lateral pressure between them or a force repelling them, which is not allowing them to move towards each other. That explains the repulsion between the like charges. Now, they all converge. There is a bulging effect done so that the length contracts. This explains the attraction between unlike charges. So these lines of forces, they explain so many things. All right. Important thing to be understood over here is, say for example, any of the diagram we discuss, okay, it's representing electric field for a given situation. Wherever the lines of forces are close to each other, in this situation, you can see the arrow. Here the lines of forces are close to each other. There the electric field strength is high. Wherever they are apart from each other, the electric field strength is low. So let's talk about the properties of lines of forces as discussed with the help of the diagram. The line of force will start from positive charge and end at negative charge. The lines of forces always originate or terminate at negative, and they are at right angles to the surface of the charge. Lines of forces do not pass through conductor. What does that indicate? It indicates that the electric field inside the conductor is zero. The lines of forces, as said earlier, never intersect. Now, in case two lines of forces intersect, then what will happen? It will mean that at that point, there are two directions of electric field. And it never happens in practice. Okay, there won't be two directions at a single point. Therefore, the lines of forces can never intersect. The relative closeness of lines of forces in the different regions of the space will give us an idea about the relative strengths of the electric field in those regions. As I have said, where they are closer, the electric field will be strong, and where they are spaced apart or you know, the distance between them is more, the field would be comparatively weak. Then, moreover, the lines of forces basically contract longitudinally or lengthwise. Now, what is it indicating? It indicates the attraction between the unlike charges. Now, as I've said earlier also, the lines of forces exert a lateral pressure on each other. therefore they are not intersecting also. So this is actually explaining, this property of lines of force is explaining the repulsion between the two like charges. Thank you.